What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel and welcome to this week's What's for Dinner video. I'm going to share with you guys four meals that I fed my family this past week that we thoroughly enjoyed and I think that you will like too. If you're new here, hello and welcome. My name is Jennifer. I am so happy you stopped by. I share grocery hauls, meal plans, and What's for Dinner videos on this channel every single week. And if you are returning, thank you so much for coming back. I appreciate you. We're going to get on into this video now, guys. I hope you guys enjoy. Alrighty, you guys, we are going to start this week off with a bacon cheeseburger chili. It was actually starting to feel like fall outside here in North Carolina, and I just wanted to like have a different take on chili this night. We did build a bonfire in our backyard, and we were just having all the fall vibes. So I'm not really sure who to accredit this recipe to. I found it in my recipe binder in a little winter cookbook that has no names on it, but I will type out all the ingredients for you and the directions in the description box below. So these are all the ingredients that you will need to make this recipe. We also air fried some corn on the cob for a side. Alright, so starting out here in my pot, I am adding about a tablespoon of oil, and I'm going to go ahead and brown up my hamburger meat. Alright, next I'm going to add in a half of a large onion that I had chopped up pretty good here, and also two cloves of garlic. And we're just going to cook that until the onions become translucent. Alrighty, so once the onion and the hamburger and garlic are all ready to rock and roll, I've got one package of chili seasoning mix here that I'm going to add in. Then we're going to go ahead and add in about 16 ounces of chunky salsa. I'm just using the Great Value brand here. One can of chili ready tomatoes. One can of beef broth. 1/4 cup of smoky barbecue sauce, 1 15-ounce can of kidney beans that I had washed and drained, and 3 tablespoons of mustard. And I am eyeballing that. Alrighty, and we're gonna go ahead and get these ingredients all mixed together. We're gonna cover and simmer this for just a little while, and meanwhile, I did decide that my chili needed more beans in it. So I found a can of chili beans in my pantry and I drained and rinsed those and added those in. So now I'm going to go ahead and cover this bad boy up and just let it cook for about 10 minutes just to get all the ingredients nice and warm. Once it's simmered long enough, I am going to go ahead and add in 8 ounces of my Velveeta cheese. That would be Great Value's brand of Velveeta. And we're going to go ahead and incorporate that. We'll go ahead and put the lid back on and we'll let that cook and then let the cheese get all nice and melted in there. Alrighty, and dinner is done, but it is piping hot. So I'm gonna go ahead and spoon some of this up into some bowls and set it aside. Meanwhile, in my air fryer, which you don't see right now, but I've got some corn going on 400 degrees for 10 minutes on both sides. You guys, I have never had corn on the cob that was more delicious than that. All right, you guys, so this is what we had for dinner this night, and it was so delicious. Let me know if you try it. All All right, you guys, I don't know if anyone else remembers, but Taco Bell used to offer Mexi Melts, and oh my goodness, they were so delicious. So we're giving these a try tonight. So thank you, Courtney, over at the Browse Bunch for bringing these to my attention, because OMG. So here I have browned 1 pound of ground beef, and I'm adding in some taco seasoning. I do make my own. I found a recipe that is just delicious. I will leave that down below for you. And then I'm putting in 1/2 cup of water to get that seasoning incorporated well. Alrighty, and so here I'm gonna go ahead and shred up some mild cheddar cheese, because you know around here we love all the cheese. Did y'all just see that fly land on my cutting board? I swear, I go after 90 million flies in this kitchen every single night. All right, so I have put a tortilla in the microwave, well, 2 tortillas in the microwave for about 20 seconds with a wet paper towel over top. And now I'm just gonna spoon on some hamburger meat and put some cheese on the top. And now we're gonna go ahead and add on some pico de gallo. You add as much as you like. This was just how much I liked and how much I could fit in that burrito. I was maxing it out for sure. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this back up in a wet paper towel, and I'm gonna set it aside, and I'm gonna make another one here. This was a night that Jeff was at work, so it was just me and the boys, so I'm just making a couple of them. Alrighty, we're gonna go ahead and throw these back in the microwave for just a couple of seconds to warm them back up, and supper is ready, you guys. It is that easy. So I did go ahead and cut mine in half, and I poured on some of that Taco Bell sauce you see there. Alrighty, and this is what we had for dinner this night. They were amazing. Alrighty, you guys, if you like a chicken parmesan at all, you have got to try this recipe. This was amazing. And I've also been told that it is even better made into meatballs. So I've got to try that soon. All right, so I have went ahead and preheated my oven to 350 degrees. And I'm going to go ahead and get the cheeses all grated up and shredded. Here I have grated up 1/2 cup of Parmesan. And then also I'm going to grate up 1/2 cup of mozzarella. All right, to a bowl, I have 1 pound of ground chicken. I'm gonna go ahead and add in 1 egg that I have lightly beaten, 1/2 cup of breadcrumbs, 1 teaspoon of Italian seasoning, and you can add 2 or 3 cloves of garlic. I added 3. Y'all should know I love garlic. All right, so now I'm gonna use my second favorite kitchen tool, my hands, to mix this up. My first favorite is my wooden spoon, y'all know that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add in the Parmesan cheese. All right, and then I'm gonna go ahead and add this into my loaf pan that I, after adding it, decided that it was way too big. So side note here, definitely double this recipe, you guys. There's my smaller little loaf pan. But anyway, it was plenty for the 4 of us, but if you're like me, I like to have leftovers, so next time I will be doubling this recipe. I will also leave this recipe in the description box for you below. I highly recommend it. All right, so next I'm gonna go ahead and add 1/2 cup of marinara sauce. Alrighty, and so if you are using raw ground chicken, you will need to bake this for 50 to 55 minutes. The chicken that I used in my recipe was already cooked, so I only cooked this for about 25 minutes. Okay, so now I'm going to try to get this cheese to come out of here, and it ain't. So here we go. Okay, now we're good. So we're adding on our half a cup of mozzarella cheese here, and then we're going to pop this back in the oven for 5 to 10 minutes, and then dinner will be done. Also, you guys, I've got this new air fryer that I've been loving here, and I tried to cook some fried okra in my air fryer this night as a side, and just things just didn't go well. They tasted good, but they didn't look good. So you will see that I didn't share a side this night, but that's okay. We just had some toast here and everything was fine. You guys definitely got to try this recipe out. It was amazing. Alrighty, you guys, here's one other easy night meal that we love, the boys loved, and everybody was happy. So we just made some macaroni and cheese, good old 34 cent, great value mac and cheese. I'm gonna cut up 3 hot dogs here. I did warm these in my oven on 350 for about 15 minutes. Mixed it all together. We had some leftover green beans and mashed potatoes, and dinner was served.
Alright, my friends, that is going to wrap it up for this week's What's for Dinner video. I hope you have enjoyed my video today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope I've given you some inspiration on meals to feed your family. Please comment down below if you decide to make any of these recipes. I would love to hear from you. And I hope everyone has a wonderful week. And until next time, keep them fed.